Hi, my name is Tom Altman from SEO Test Tool, and what I want to talk to you about today or explain is a SEO test that we ran recently on our website and checking to see if Google is indexing rendered JavaScript. This is a question that we've had for a little while, and not sure if you're aware of what's going on, but basically HTML we know is indexed and by Google, but what we always were curious is if you change the content of a page after the page loaded with JavaScript, does Google check that or do they know that? Company I work for, ClickStop, we have some pages that had some semi unfriendly looking pages at times. We have some long pages with lots of grid layouts like this one. Sometimes the images look a lot the same. So we decided to see what we could do with some JavaScript to render those pages differently after the page loads. So we came up with what we call a table display, and essentially what happens is after the page loads its HTML, we go back through the page and render everything back out in JavaScript with unordered lists. So you can see the unordered lists here, all these section headers and some things like that. But if we actually take an item like this, which if we find it in the JavaScript is right down here, and you can see that's nested in an li tag. If we actually view the source of that page, do the same find that that is actually in the HTML, it's actually in a div tag that's in the td. All that's done with some client-side JavaScript, and we render it that way. So basically what we wanted to know was, what does Google do with that rendered JavaScript, and are they indexing that, or are they actually indexing just the HTML that was on the page beforehand? Well, here's the test that we actually ran. We took this blog post, the one I have right here, and I'll link to that in the notes, and we created four keywords. We assigned four random keywords here, nonsense words that weren't indexed in Google prior, and then we created two pages, one page with HTML and one page with JavaScript. And we created all those, we set them out, and we actually linked to them from this blog post. My buddy Dave actually said, you know what, that might not be the best idea. Since this is an anchor text, maybe we shouldn't use that keyword to link to that JavaScript page to give Google a tip of our hat. So I created two more. These only use the titles of the page or the name of the actual HTML page, and that way it would be a little bit less kind of telling Google what we were looking for. So we ran this test, and it's kind of interesting what we found. It actually did index all of the HTML pages. So if you look at these pages, you can see that all these here that are indexed are our HTML pages, or I shouldn't say indexed. They actually indexed all our pages, but the ones that are found using these keywords are only the ones that were the HTML page. So this is a search with all of our keywords in it. And here it's showing all the different pages that we have that on. But as you notice down here, it's just the HTML pages. If we flip over here, I just did a quick site search using that with the testing URL portion in here that we needed. And you can see here, actually, we have the HTML pages and the JavaScript pages both indexed on the site. So Google knows about both of them. And if we take the first one with the bada bing oh la la keyword, you'll see it here. You won't see it here in the JavaScript. But the interesting thing is if we go ahead and open up this page, the keyword isn't in fact in here. The difference, of course, is that it's being rendered with the JavaScript. So if we take a look at keyword number 5, gooby gooby doo, no, there it is. There it is in the HTML. If we view the source, here it is again in the HTML. We take that same page and look at the keyword 5 JavaScript. Notice it's not here in the SERP. It is showing here, but it's not in the JavaScript. It's not in the HTML here because we actually render the JavaScript out and we switch the content out at runtime. So all the things are there. One more interesting note here is, like we said, we don't see that keyword here, but if we look at the cached version, look at that right there. See that? That's actually our keyword. And if you can't quite see that, I've actually loaded up the cached version And there is our keyword in their cached version. So that is one other interesting thing that Google is doing there. So essentially what it comes down to is Google is not rendering indexed JavaScript in its search results. It definitely knows it's there, but it definitely is not rendering it. One other interesting thing to note, it used to be kind of known that if you actually linked to something using the keyword that you were looking for, Google would give you a little bonus for that. It would say, hey, baba, bing, bingo, lala, hey, this page must have something to do with it because that's where they're linking to it. But seeing as how this has no content on the other, on the resulting target page, they actually are not indexing that anymore like that. So that's kind of an interesting note to them. So if you have any questions about this, I probably was a little more confusing than I wanted to be, but I'd love to hear your comments, love to hear some questions, and let me know if I can explain things more. Until the next time, thanks for tuning in, and we'll catch you at the next test. Thanks a lot.